I'm not gonna be that guy.
Yeah.
If Errol gets knocked out, I'm not gonna be that guy and say, well, he got beat up. No.
Yeah.
Terence got up in there and whooped his ass. Yeah. Terence is probably good.
You do got to look at what they bring in the ring, though.
Yeah, but I feel like Brooke Terence is that damn good.
And too. Right, Brooke passed the test. Looking at him. But you know, if it is fair, let's say Errol comes in and we just see it. He's not the same guy. It is fair. I don't think it's taking credit away from Danny if that's what happens.
Because I just don't like to take credit from guys.
No.
And I feel like they went up there and got the job.
Because I think even yesterday, somebody who didn't watch that fight maybe afterwards says, oh, of course he knocked out Kell Brook. It was good, but whatever. Right.
But you didn't watch.
But they didn't watch that he was probably losing to Kell Brook. Yep. But it was. I thought it was a very, very great performance from Bud. And
I've never been more convinced that, like, we always wanted Crawford Spence, but I've never been more convinced that it's actually a great fight in the it's going to be a war.
Such a great fight.
Yeah, because Crawford is just this great. He's. What they say, he's 12 knockouts, 15-0 in title fights. No one's went the distance with him since Postal, and he dropped him twice. Mm. The guy is exciting to watch. Mm-hmm. And then Errol was in the fight of the year last year with you. So I've never been more convinced that, because we usually demand these fights because it's the best versus the best.
Yeah.
And we'll see if it actually plays out into a great fight. But I've never been more convinced that Crawford and Spence is like a fight of the year type of fight.
And even if we do get that fight, let's say Errol goes on, beats Danny, rematch Sean, beats Sean. You didn't put him in with Pacquiao 2022? I say, Errol, get all your money on this side.
Nah, I
know we want it. Yeah. I know.
Yeah.
We're talking reality here.
Yeah, reality. Yeah. Say, clean up on your side.
And so I gave Bob Arum credit earlier.
Well Sean, maybe Sean beat Errol then so you could fight Terrence. So we don't have to wait so long. Terrence can get his shot.
I gave Bob Arum credit earlier.
Part of the company line.
Yeah, no, we'll get you.
It's unfortunate.
But I with Bob Arum, I gave him credit for how he dealt with the commission earlier. But then after the fight, after Bud wins, I can assure you, Errol Spence is not scared of Terence Crawford. No, I don't think Errol Spence is afraid or even threatened by any fighter.
Nobody on that side.
I don't think Bud is afraid of Errol. I don't think either of them have any fear of fighting the other one
at all. They're ready to fight.
Yeah, and so the fact that everyone always, I mean, that's boxing. That's how it goes. But to push the narrative of like, Bob Arum, Errol Spence is going to do everything he can to avoid. No, he's not. He's not at all.
It's chess moves at this point.
Yeah, and it's like those guys, of the fighters, I think you get a lot of credit for that you're willing to fight anyone. I think those guys absolutely are willing to fight anyone.
I think 90% of the boxers at the top are willing to fight just about anybody.
And I think they even are more than maybe a normal like, hey, I'll take that fight. I think they want to fight. Like Errol has been calling out people forever.
Yeah.
So he's ready to fight. And Bud Crawford, same way. I think
Errol's got a great jab. And we saw Terence getting touched up by the jab. Yeah. And if I was Errol, I'd probably be watching that saying I could do the same thing. Mm-hmm. If not, you know, but better.
I have zero clue who wins that fight. I have no idea.
I'm going with
Bud
Crawford.
Hey, Terence impressed the hell out of me last night. I'm clueless.
I have no idea. I think the style matchup is, it's almost a souped-up version of what yesterday could have been. You have Errol, who's, I think, a better athlete than Kell, and I think he has, you know, stiff, straight punches. Obviously, has good power. He's been in some wars.
Great body puncher.
So I think you have, like, a souped-up version of Kell Brook, but it's Errol Spence, like, what he brings to the table. And then Bud is just, I think he maybe has more
in his bag.
Yeah, more in his bag, and also more, I think he has more like one punch power than Errol, maybe. Like, I think he can get you with one shot, where I'm not sure Errol, not that he can't, but I think Bud maybe has more of that. But that fight would be unbelievable.
I think Errol last two fights took something off of his being a guy that can just stop people.
Think so? Well, maybe he brings it back because,
yeah.
And those two,
trash that left hand he's got looks pretty good.
Oh yeah!
I think
those two talking trash. The build up to that fight would be excellent.
Don't tell me you didn't enjoy what you saw, because I know you did. What you need to do now: hit that subscribe button, hit the like, hit that notification button. Check us out every week, every Tuesday. Something new for you right here on the Port Away Podcast.